Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom. Today I'm going to show you how to get tech help from a friend remotely using Teamviewer. We all have problems with our computers from time to time, and if you're lucky enough to have someone who's able and willing to help you, they don't have to come over. There are a bunch of ways to let them access and control your computer remotely that are safe and easy. Our favorite is an app called Teamviewer. Teamviewer is free for personal use, and it's really easy to use. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use it if you have it on your computer already. If it's not already on your computer, click the link above to get instructions for installing it. If Teamviewer is on your computer, look for its icon in the dock, this blue and white symbol, and click there once. If you don't have the icon in the dock, click Spotlight and start typing T-E-A-M. The computer now shows you everything that has the word team in it on your computer, including this app. So when I click on that app in the list, Teamviewer will start. If you're running Teamviewer for the first time, you'll see this window to configure permissions. That's because Teamviewer doesn't come from the App Store, so Apple wants to be sure that it's safe to run. So here's how to do it. Click Configure Permissions, then open System Preferences. In the window that appears, you've got to click this lock and enter your computer password, not your Apple ID password, but your login password, to unlock it and allow you to give TeamViewer permission to run. That's all you have to do, and you only have to do it once. Now TeamViewer is ready to connect, and all you have to do is read your ID and your password right here to the person who's going to help you. They'll have started TeamViewer on their end. Your partner types that information into TeamViewer on their end, and you'll see the green dot turn yellow as they are connecting, and then the big window disappears, your desktop background changes, and you'll see this little window that shows they're connected. A computer can only take instruction from one person at a time, so be sure to coordinate with your partner as to who is typing or using the mouse, one of you at a time. Now the person has access to my computer and can open windows or run programs or do whatever they need to do. When I'm done, I click on this button to bring the TeamViewer controls back up and close the window. The desktop background goes back to normal, and I'm done. You can also quit TeamViewer from the menu like this. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching, and please click like if you found this video helpful.